Bunchy boy sitting on the wall. That's the one who caused so much disturbance on Saturday. That's Brian Larkin. Their father is a Harrison police officer. May 24th, 1993, time, 4:30 p.m., the day, Monday. This is Brian Larkin and a small boy who's been bouncing the ball up against our wall, who doesn't live here, and the tallest boy of all, who doesn't live here, and the younger El Pucci boy. Brian Larkin. Those two are outside. Andrew Larkin, I mean Brian Larkin. An outsider. The younger El Pucci. And then the black boy is an outsider. Time is 4:45 p.m. That's Brian Larkin. His father is a Harrison policeman. This has been going on since 4:30 p.m. Anything that they're doing can be done any place. And yet, this one family, this two families right now, it's El Pucci and Larkin, have to spoil the complex for 13 other families. There's Kevin Larkin, that's an outsider, and that's the younger El Pucci, and there's two outsiders. And this has been going on since 4:30 this afternoon. It's 5 o'clock now. And it's May 24th, 1993. The ball just hit the wall at 5:22.
This better be kidding, camera!
That's Kevin Larkin. His father is a Harrison policeman. Time is 5:33.
You get 5 times.
The ball hit our wall and the bedroom wall. Then the ball hit our car. Now, that first boy, I think, is Andrew. He's an outsider. The next one's Kevin Larkin. The next one's a younger Alpucci. The next one is an outsider. And the next one is Brian Larkin. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that's 6. And this one is an outsider, too. This is the Indian. It's been going on since 4:30. The time now is 5:47. That's an hour and a quarter. It's Kevin Larkin, it's the young Alpucci, it's Brian Larkin, it's the Indian boy outsider, it's the black boy outsider, and it's that little kid outsider. The Indian boy is an outsider. The one next to him is Kevin Harkin. The one next to him is a younger Alpucci. The one next to the younger Alpucci is Kevin Harkin. And then there's the little boy who's an outsider and the Indian boy who's an outsider.
All right, come on, play
ball. Isn't that nice? And I think that breaks the penal code. Section 240.20. Disorderly conduct. Kevin Larkin. Kevin Larkin. I think this has been going on. It's 4:30. Yeah, 6 o'clock. Come on, come on. May 24, 1993, Monday. This is the Larkin family and the Alpucci family. And 3 outsiders.
No jump, no jump.
I jumped.
No jump.
I was in the air.
No,
I called it all the time. I was in the air.
That was no jump.
I was already on line.
No, I always get TPP. Go.
Devin, the hurry on line. First of all, this kid's been out for like 10 minutes.
No, no. Oh, I mean, keep my head up.
Hey! B, C, D, E, F.
I'm champion!
Kevin Larkin. Indian boy outsider. Black boy outsider. Two of the outsiders went. That was Kevin Larkin, who just went by. That's an outsider, and that's James Walsh. 6:14 p.m. Okay, today is May the 25th, 1993, Tuesday. The time is 6 p.m. This has been going on since 5:40 p.m. And many of these people are outsiders. I'll let you hear it first, and then I'll show you the characters.
Hey,
Now, a man was just talking to Brian Larkin, and the man looked a lot like Brian Larkin. And my guess said it was Andrew Larkin, who was a Harrison police officer. And he was giving Brian Larkin instructions, but Andrew Larkin is not stopping this noise one bit. Okay, that is Brian Larkin, and that's the outsider from yesterday. And Kevin Larkin is also here. Kevin Larkin is to the right on the wall, our bedroom wall. And then there's another outsider. He's an outsider. And a new outsider, first time today. There's another outsider. And that's Kevin Larkin.
He's my friend. You got a problem?
Kevin Larkin.
I'm new. No joke.
And there's the Oriental Boys there. So how many is that all together? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Only the Larkins live here. The other four are outsiders.
Talking to Glenn Drake, and while I was on the phone, they all went by the window out to the front. And when I looked, Dick Young was getting into his car. So he must have said something to them. They'd been noisy, as I say, for nearly an hour. And he must have said something to them because they went out to the front, and then they played in the front on the lawn. Until 5 o'clock, they came back here. And they've come and gone since then. One time there were only two or three, and then it built up again. But they were never as noisy as they were earlier. But they did come back here at 5 o'clock, and it's now, 5:20 or so.
You say there were seven of them?
Seven, yeah. There was Walsh and the younger Pucci, and two Larkins, and three outsiders.
Well, the older El Pucci's out there now.
He's out there now, yeah.
And now they're playing on the front lawn. Well, and when I came in the door, they threw the ball at me.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. That would be at 5:20 p.m.
Yeah, now I think they've all left.
Into our entrance, who is an outsider, is the Indian boy.
Well, yeah, he came up the stairs. Just as I came up to see you, he didn't see me. He came up the stairs and went out the front door.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, what date is it? It's May the 26th, 1993, Wednesday. And they've been noisy since 3:30 to what? 3:30 to 5:20?
3:24 to 4:24 when Dick Young came out. And then they went out on the front lawn.
Well, it's gone on from 3:24 to 5:24. That's
yeah,
2 hours.
That's right.
Roberto and Caesar were here to witness the noise. And there's Kevin, there's Brian Larkin. And that's that little outsider boy. That's Brian Larkin. The boy's an outsider, the Oriental is an outsider, the younger Al Pucci, and Kevin Larkin. Time is 6:25 p.m. This noise has been going on for 3 hours straight from 3:25 p.m. The loudest voice is Kevin Larkin. The loudest and the sassiest. Well, maybe the sassiest is the old Al Pucci. The old Al Pucci, every time he goes by our bedroom window, and that's quite often and very much on purpose, looks into our bedroom window. He's done it 3 times today. So this is right outside our bedroom window. You're looking to the east, to the southeast, really. Kevin Larkin, the younger Al Pucci, and of course the two outsiders. 6:44 p.m. This noise started at 3:24 p.m. and has gone 3 hours and 20 minutes. May the 26th, 1993, Wednesday. Kevin Larkin and James Walsh, and the time is 3:41 p.m. and the date is May 27, 1993, Thursday. South bedroom window, and this is the noise that the older Al Pucci boy, along with the outsider, the Indian boy, this is an example of the noise that they kept up for a solid 5 or 6 hours on April the 24th, 1993, Saturday. Now this was more than just noise, it was harassment. They deliberately bounce this basketball right outside of this window. And then to add to that, they made the vocal noise. Listen. Oh. And I repeat, this is how it went for 5 hours on that Saturday, April the 24th. Continued unabated, and here is a report and also a call to John Porzio, the owner. Again, this is April 24th, 1993, Saturday. Here's another incident off of this audio tape of April the 24th, 1993, Saturday. Was made to John Porzio earlier on May the 24th, 1993, Saturday. Mm-hmm. This is taken off of audio tape. Skin boy, the littlest boy of all, and of course Kevin Larkin, and the younger Al Pucci.
Come on.
What time is it? 5 p.m.? What day is it? June the 1st, 1993, Tuesday, right after Memorial Day. There was a basketball, and I guess this is a volleyball. Okay, they have dispersed because of the camera. I'll be back later. The girl who went by is not a party to the action.
No, that was not over.
This is the old Al Pucci, the one who's caused so much trouble. That's James Walsh.
Got this dribbling display here.
Here. Kevin Mark. No, that's the littlest boy, the dark-skinned boy. Kevin Larkin is to the southeast. The ball just hit Mr. Young's car.
Hold on, we gotta wait for Brian.
And that's the Indian boy. So right here is the Indian boy. Time on that was 5:06 p.m. And the date is June the 1st, 1993. And the day is Monday.
Come on.
I'm going to play for you an audio recording. And it's about Candy Alpucci. Glendora had a consultant from Con Edison here about the electric bill. And he spent quite a lot of time examining the various electrical appliances. And he also looked at the meters down cellar, and we were up and down cellar. And all the time that this was going on, Candy Alpucci, Mrs. Alpucci, and Roberta Walsh, Mrs. Walsh, were up and down the stairs doing a lot of laundry work. Okay, and I think the audio tape will tell you the rest.
That blonde and brunette are easy to get along with in redhead. Well, my wife has been all three. I don't
care.
Very good. Mac, thanks for coming.
All right,
I'm all well. I sure do feel a lot better about that. Take care. I'll talk to you soon, huh?
All right, thank you. Have a good day.
Yeah. Bye-bye. Oh, there goes Kenny with you.
Oh.
Audio tape to videotape. So I backed it up and I'm just going to splice it together here.
10:21 a.m. Jeannie ran out the door as McGuire was leaving, and Jeannie ran down the cellar stairs, and Alpucci started her.
Histrionics.
Her comments, and then she slammed the cellar door at Jeannie. And Alpucci put the chair up against the cellar door. And then, of course, Jeannie ran in terror up the stairs. The time of that was 10:22 a.m. And the date was April 30th, 1993, Friday. Good morning, 9495.
Hello, Gwenny.
Oh, hello there. How are you?
Pretty good.
Good. I'm going to play an audio tape, April the 30th, 1993, 4:04 p.m. This is Jamie Walsh. See how you would like to listen to this.
Thank you.
record of your existence so far. It's very bad.
Okay, there's an 800 number I've instructed to call by the other telephone company. Just call it.
This basketball bouncing would go on for hours, and it was right outside of our south and east bedroom windows.
Up the stairs, making a whole lot of unnecessary noise, which constitutes harassment. He was on the east side of the building, then he came through the cellar and up the stairs. He was out there in the east side, calling Glendora and taunting. And what time was that?
That was 5:16 p.m. 5:36 p.m. June 2nd, 1993, Tuesday. Videotaping was good for me because it helped slim my hips.
Mm-hmm. 6:05 p.m., June the 2nd, 1993. I was sitting at my desk telephoning. Daniel Waltz went by. Roberta Waltz went by. And she says, "Yoo-hoo, yoo-hoo, idiot." And she just went by again, this time to the west. First time was to the east, saying, "Yoo-hoo, yoo-hoo." Daniel Walsh has passed three times in the past 5 minutes by my window, but he hasn't looked in and he hasn't said anything. This audio tape that I'm going to play for you, I'm going to transfer it to videotape. And it happened on May the 8th, 1993, and it was a Saturday. And Roberta Walsh at 2:16 p.m. Started a harassment with a video camera. She got a video camera, which I really think is non-functional. And this is what she did, and these are the words she spoke. So Roberta got her son to get the basketball and to play in the area where the landlord asked them not to play. And she egged him on, and the son was really reluctant. James Waltz, he really didn't want to do that. But she kept at him to do it.
This next audio tape was on May the 11th, 1993, Tuesday. It was the day of the Texaco annual meeting. I was talking to Fran, Ira Birnbaum's secretary. Ira Birnbaum is the general manager of TCI Cable TV. We were sitting at our window. We were sitting at our desk, facing the south, and it was in the afternoon, around 4 o'clock. And Daniel Walsh went by. Nobody had spoken to him, and just out of the blue, he says,
"Bye, bye." That's Fran at Cable Television. And the time is 10:08 a.m. I have to dress up to go to the Texaco annual meeting. May the 11th, 1993, Tuesday.
I appreciate you, man.
That was Daniel Walsh. And that was at 3:05 p.m. And that was May the 11th, 1993, Tuesday. And he said, "Hey, thanks for the letter. And thanks." He never answered. Their attorney sent a letter to sent me a copy of a letter she wrote to Schwartzberg asking for a 30-day extension, but she never answered the complaint. Andy Alpucci at 7:55 a.m. and that radio you just heard going under our bedroom window on May the 18th, 1993, Tuesday.
This was a telephone call. It's on audio tape, and I'm going to play it for you. It happened on June the 1st, 1993, which was a Tuesday.
By the time of that call, well, just as we went outdoors, which would be 5:15, and it's 1993, June 1st, Monday, Tuesday. Okay, I'm going to put a stoplight on here. Over there. Do I do that, man? Thank you.
Yes. Good afternoon, 9495.
The first of the harassment calls, the aggravated harassment calls. There was one right after that, and then there were where somebody talked, and then there were several where somebody made a suckling noise, and then there were several with silence. And at 8:50 p.m. that night, we turned off the, we unplugged the telephones. And the next morning, there were several, oh, maybe eight. These were aggravated harassments where the person called with no intention to have a conversation and with and silence. And these have continued since that night, June the 1st, to June 2nd, which was Wednesday, June 3rd, which was Thursday, and today, June 4th, which is Friday. And there have been quite a few of them. And of course, the prime suspect is Roberta Walsh, because the calls during the day appear when the children are in school, so that eliminates the children, and Candy Alpucci is not even on the property, Really, the only one home is Roberta Walsh. And Friday, around 12:50 p.m., after the second harassment call, after I came home, I said, Roberta Walsh. And within 1 minute, she was at my south bedroom window, taunting, hello, Glendora. And then her husband appeared, and he was very, very angry. Stop sliding all over the place. Now, I'm going to play the second harassment call for you. It was again on June the 1st, 1993, Tuesday.
That was Lorraine McGinty at 5:45 p.m. on Tuesday, June 1st.
Good afternoon, 9495.
Hi, how are you? Is this Glendora?
Wednesday.
Yes, I'll be right with you.
Yes, I'm right here. I'm sorry.
Okay, I have one family.
Date is 6/3/93/30.
and hang up. And put down the time. Okay, so this recorder's queued up.
Good morning, 9495.
Day 8:31 a.m. and the time is the date is 6/3/93. F's birthday. Silence and hang up. And put down the time. Okay, so this recorder's queued up.
Good morning, 9495.
Another one, and the time is 8:34 a.m. So, I think that it's the same people as last night. I unplugged the phone last night. At 8:50. There was no telling how many there were then. I got to get my work done, so I will, if I just put on a recorder and screen the calls. If that's in the daytime, if the kids had gone to school, that would eliminate the kids, and that would leave you with Roberta Walsh, because Daniel Walsh had gone to work. Candy Alcucci is here. Her car is here. Okay, so now I make the suspects number one, Roberta Walsh, number two, Candy Alcucci. At 8:45 a.m. was number three of today, and I put on the telephone answering machine and left it blank. There was no message by me on there. And this person was just silent again and hung up. This is good. This is really good.
Good morning, 9495.
Morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, I'm having a call with somebody named Black.
Today is 1:09 p.m., June
8th,
1993, Tuesday.
Yeah.
Right there.
You need a new lock? Yeah. You need a new lock? Correct. What was the problem? Full of crazy glue. Crazy glue? That's correct.
All right. So, pulling on, okay?
Very good.
Thank you, John.
Okay.
Thank you. I'll talk to you again.
I'll be right back.
He said he'd be right back, John. Time is 2:08 p.m. That's the last message I'm forwarding.
City Court.
It was Kathy Ritchie.
Okay. All right. Yes. Okay.
Okay, that was about 1:45 p.m. Caesar talked to John Forzio. And today is June the...
You heard all that. That was Daniel Walsh. He certainly wanted you to hear all that. The time is 2:50 p.m. and the date is June the 10th, 1993, Thursday.
This happened somewhere between after 2 p.m. yesterday, Friday, June the 11th. 1993. Don't you see this geranium plant? It was either stepped on or pulled up. This geranium plant was left intact. This geranium plant was all right. And this one was all right. And this patient's plant was all right. These are the wild plants that were pulled up or broken. There's three of those. And then over here, there are two patients' plants. You can see. See that one there? Lying on its side. And then there's another one. This one right here, looks so pretty. This patient's plant was left alright, and this one was left alright. There's another patient's plant here. June the 12th, Saturday, 1993, at 5:50 a.m. This tomato plant was all right, and this tomato plant was okay. Then this tomato plant over here. This has been the third vandalizing and brutalizing of these plants. This got thrown over here, the tab for the label of the plant. This is a beautiful field. Covers about 10 lots. June the 12th, 1993. 3 days before Flag Days, 1993. Saturday, 6 a.m.
I water, though. See the little wildflowers? I just watered these about an hour before we left. This is Candy Alpucci. Every morning she does this. 30 minutes. And she just blew the horn. And this is between 7 and 7:30 a.m. Today happens to be June the 16th, 1993. June the 16th, 1993, Wednesday. And I don't have a doormat. And there's my doormat. Looks to me like my doormat has been kicked. This is June the 16th, 1993, Wednesday. Time is 10:37 a.m. My doormat has been kicked from the front of my door down to here. Same warning that the summer was off. Vandalized.
I'm asking you to go. Yes. Kid.
Yeah, I got you.
This is Kevin Larkin and the black boy and the third boy, and it's 5:14 p.m. and it's June 16th, 1993, Wednesday.
Me.
This has been going on for quite a while. James Walsh. That's Kevin Larkin. That's 5:26 p.m. June 16th, 1993, Wednesday. Just 2 minutes ago, the old El Pucci threw the ball at our window. He's the great window breaker anyway. He's the one who broke the window with a hockey puck. Andrew. Who is Andrew? Through the ball at the window.
Good afternoon. How are you today?
This is the old El Pucci boy who just threw the ball at me at the window. Straight at the window. He's the great window breaker, as you know.
Come on, everybody over here. Everybody's a shooter.
A sweet guy like me. Threw a ball at you. Can you believe that? Raheem, come here, man. Raheem.
Whoever's an intruder comes over here. I'm an intruder.
You believe I threw the ball at
you?
Come on. Intruders.
There's all the intruders.
I'll put it in here.
Yeah,
what? My mom's up there. You can tape her, too. This is my friend Raheem. He's from Atlanta. You can tape him, too. What? All right.
He'll be on TV.
Say, wave hi to the camera, man. You're going to be on public access.
Yeah. Pretend you're like
public access. Who's
public
that?
Access, man. Cause
oh, that's
can't
you
make,
mean?
Yeah, they can't make it. They can't make
Yo,
it.
Come on.
We're gonna barbecue under your window just to bother you. Just... Yeah, I'm finished. All right, man. Bye, we're leaving now. Yeah, I'm finished.
That's a new person.
Who's the man with the mask?
This is Kevin Larkin. Kevin Larkin. James Walsh. P.M. The date is June 18, 1993, Friday. Okay, they are hiding from the camera at the moment.
Can you blow his horn again so I'll play it for you on audio tape?
Yes. D-O-R-A, box 532, Scarsdale, New York, 10583.
Okay, thank you very much for calling.
Thank you. What's your name?
Becca.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, that's 4:18 p.m. This is Uncle Ozzy who just blew his phone in the corner a few minutes ago. 4:18 p.m. He's backing out that big camera. He drives in here as if he lived here and had a parking space. Okay, there it is again. Okay, there it is again.
So that's 4:18 p.m., and that's on June 22nd, 1993, Tuesday. Guess he doesn't know that the boys are going to be interviewed tomorrow.
Kevin Larkin, of course, and that's his brother Brian. And that's the younger El Pucci with the hat on backwards. No, yeah, the hat on backwards. Chinese boy.
It's a video camera.
Yeah, there
are movies. Is there a behind?
And that's the littlest boy. Has just put his shirt over his head. That's a Chinese boy. The ball just hit the car.
Oh, yeah, fine. It's all like that. I'm really gonna go for it.
So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And now I can see the time. It's 7:22 p.m. And the date is 6:22 p.m. Tuesday, second day of summer. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And now I can see the time. It's 7:22 p.m. And the date is 6:22 p.m. Tuesday, second day of summer. This is in violation of the White Plains Noise Ordinance.
Did. No, it was cool. Wow.
to go to jail, all right?
For what?
For blasting.
For bad-mouthing her? I'm going to get arrested for that?
No, I
wouldn't. No, I wouldn't do that. She's not worth it.
You know, it's a problem. She don't have a wife.
Hi. Hello.
She's getting taped. You're going to be out.
She's an idiot.
She's a moron. She needs a good pick up her ass. Fuck her. Fucking mental case. I'm not going to do this until your mother comes home. All she right. needs a good piece of ass. That's because she got no kids. She probably can't have any. That's what's her problem.
That's Franklin wasted.
You guys go finish playing. I'll barbecue after.
All right.
Let's go finish playing. Who is it?
Andrew? No.
You peace?
If you had kids of your own, you wouldn't be doing this. Maybe you can't have any.
You want to give her the time, then, Kevin?
Huh? Take 4:50.
Now, I think that must be Candy L. Pucci's sister. They certainly had the same mouth. That's Brian Larkin. He lives over there. 1C. Now, what time was this? 5:22 p.m. What day was it? June 23rd, 1993, Wednesday.
I wouldn't.
Oh boy. Now, how are we going to get this out of this side? First,
Thank you.
was assault, and that was Roberta Walt, and I'll call the police tomorrow.
What's she saying?
You know, all the troubles that Candy Alpucci and Ferdinand Alpucci caused with this car parked so close to our bedroom. And you see, there should not. This is only one parking space. Everybody else has one parking space. And they have to cheat with two. See, this disabled van. And this is how close it is to our bedroom. Now I'm going to go outdoors. I'm going to show you how it looks outdoors. This car is to our bedroom. There's our bedroom where you just were. Now you see these two barbecues? They should not be here. It's on common property. It's on the common ground, the common area. There's a disabled van. Now I'll give you her license number. And look at this bag of rubbish she leaves. And then if you go over there, you'll find the place is littered with cigarette butts. Today is June the 24th, 1993. And the camera is focusing on the screen. And the time is 7:07. Yeah. Videotape I'm going to record for you on videotape is of Candy Alpucci and Roberta Walsh. Warning, children should not listen to this. The language is vile. It is crude. It is obscene. It happened at 5:55 p.m. on June the 23rd. 1993 Wednesday night. Franklin and I were loading the TV monitor and the camcorders and the videotapes and the backpack full of accessories into the Lincoln. And Candy Alpucci and Roberta Walsh started this harangue. It is not pleasant, and you shouldn't be eating when you listen to it.
You know why? Because you're an evil, evil woman. sound do we have?
Go ahead.
Thank you. I think that it ought to be reported.
Where are you calling me from?
21 Greenridge Avenue.
What apartment?
I'm in apartment 2A. She's in apartment 3A.
Is that Roberta?
Walsh. Her name is Walsh, W-A-L-S-H.
Your name, please?
Is Mrs. Buell, B-U-E-L-L. And she's home now.
Okay, why don't you tell me one more time what happened to Mrs. Buell?
Okay, well, we came home, and there was the chair from down cellar was in front of our door.
You came home together?
My husband and I, excuse me. My husband, Mr. Buell, and I came home.
Yep.
And a chair from down cellar was in front of our door, so I videotaped it. And as I did that, they started taunting me, and I was at my front door, and they started coming up the stairs, and I videotaped their taunting.
Okay, let me...
At that point, she put her hand...
Let me take your telephone number down.
Sure. She put her hand over the lens of my expensive camera.
Is your camera damaged in any way?
Well, I haven't had an opportunity to determine that. I'd have to have daylight to do that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what's my number? 949...
Huh?
Uh-huh. 9495.
9495. And you're in apartment 2A, correct?
Yes, officer.
Okay, I'm going to have officer come over and speak to you.
Oh, good. And your name is what, officer?
L-E-E.
L-E-E. Officer Lee.
That's correct.
Thank you, Officer Lee.
Yep.
I appreciate it.
Okay.
Bye. From the appellate division is not signed. The time on Broder today is 1:30. Parking garage to get my car at 3:00. The tire was flat. I want you to really see this 2x4. There's no need of that. To leave that there day in and day out. Go down into the parking garage.
As I say, I think I ought to have a contest and give away all these hats, all these umbrellas, and all these t-shirts. Page 31, April the 17th, 1993, Saturday. This is a fact sheet. And
original plaid stamps.